Hi there, my name is Guy Yehuda. I'm the clarinet professor at Michigan State University and also the principal clarinet player at the Lansing Symphony and a soloist as well. I've played Vandoren throughout my career, and when I was a kid, I remember I used to play, my first reed was the blue box, the traditional Vandoren reed, and I remember when the V12 came out, that was a wonderful surprise and quite a nice change from the blue box, which was a nice change of sound. Lately, I'm experimenting with the Rouleau Pique 56, and I find them very nice and responsive with a nice core in the sound. And here you see it's a nice combination with the optimum ligature. As I travel and perform concerts all over the world, I also record quite a lot, and there's actually a new CD coming out in the next month of 6 commissioned pieces from composers around the world. And the title of the CD is Rhapsodies Around the World. And of course, the most famous rhapsodies written for us is the Debussy Rhapsody. So on that CD, it will be the Debussy Premier Rhapsody and 6 other rhapsodies from composers that I commissioned from Europe, from China, from Africa, and etc. And it's a very interesting CD. Will come out in late of May, beginning of June, and you can find it on iTunes and in stores near you. I will be at ICA this summer in Orlando, playing a solo recital. Some of the commissioned pieces I just mentioned, I'll play on that recital. I'll be at the Vandoren booth to sign CDs and posters and talk about clarinet and life in general. As a professor at Michigan State University, I work with many students on all aspects of playing the clarinet and music. And of course, for us clarinet players, sound is one of the most important things in playing music, if not maybe the most important thing. And we always go back to the basics, which of course for us is air support. And I think if the air support is correct from the beginning, everything else will fall into place. It's like a pyramid. If you take the big block that you build the pyramid and right from the bottom there, and you take it away, the whole thing will crumble. That's why I work diligently with my students about sound and tone production. And what I'm trying to instill in their playing is really searching for the beautiful sound, the core of the sound. And just to demonstrate, if I play a low G, like I started to play Rigoletto Fantasy, which starts with low G. It's not just a G. G is the fundamental note, and as you know, we have overtones, a stack of overtones over the G, and the clarinet, of course, is a unique instrument that has the 12 as the most prominent first partial. That gives the clarinet its unique sound. And if you start to train your ear to hear those partials, your sound will grow to be a beautiful round sound. So as you play this G, try to see if you can hear the D and move into the D. And if you get really good at it, you can start to hear that D, that upper partial, embedded in the G. And the more you train yourself to hear those overtones, the more your sound will be beautiful. And an added bonus, your projection will actually be a wonderful projection when you play in the orchestra, and you'll be able to reach all the way to the back seat.